Glück auf, Friends of Light. Let's talk about the Light Painter's Flashlight. This is a flashlight created especially for light painting purposes, and you can get it over at Light Painting Paradise. As some of you might know, I'm the creator of this flashlight, so I thought I can give you a little bit of insight of how it works and what you can do with it. But a little disclaimer for YouTube, I don't get paid for this video, and no one but me has control over it, so technically this is no advertisement and is also not meant to be an advertisement. I just want to show you how you can control this light and what you can do with it. So let's get over some technical details. It can reach a peak brightness of around 1200 lumens. It has a pretty normal head diameter, so it can fit into almost any adapter that's out there. There's also a special one on Light Painting Paradise from Carl Scalero. And there's also one that I made. I can put the link of it to it in the description. And it fits perfectly for this flashlight too. It has a side button to control almost all the functions and a back button to turn it on and off. The flashlight has a continuous light mode like any other flashlight, three different strobe modes and a single flash mode. The strobe modes are a regular strobe, a flash strobe and what I call a ribbon strobe. You can select the setting of each mode with a single press. So in continuous light mode you select the brightness that's also used for the strobes, and in the strobe modes you select the speed of the strobe. With a double press, you circle through the strobe modes in the order that I've just told you. And once you reach the end, it circles back to the front. You can save each mode and setting by holding the side button for around 3 to 5 seconds, like this. And the lamp will confirm with 2 blinks. And whenever you power it on, it will always return to the stored setting and mode. So this is continuous light mode. And as a little bonus, you can not only control it by the back button with power on and off, but when you hold the side button while powering on, the flashlight will flash twice. And now the side button is sort of a switch. So when you press it, the light is on. You press it again, the light is off. This works with any mode, so you can control it very detailed. And you can go out of this control mode by powering it off and on again, and now you can select another mode. If you hold the button longer, it flashes twice and then 3 times. And now it's in a momentary mode, so the light is on whenever I hold the button. So only while I hold the button and when I let it loose, it goes off. There's one special thing in the flash mode. Let's go to it. The light will turn off to indicate that's in this mode. You need to save this. It confirms with a double flash. And now if I go into the other control mode, each time I press a button, it emits a single 5 millisecond burst of light. This can be used to create very interesting patterns because you can freeze any kind of tool you put on the flashlight in mid-air with this. And you have perfect control on when to flash and where to flash. So let's go over the strobe modes. The first one is a regular strobe mode where the on and off time is always the same. This is a little bit different from most other flashlights because the manufacturers put in irregular strobe modes like 30 second off and 2/3 of a second on. But this one will always have a regular on and off time. So if you take a second, it's 1/2 second on, 1/2 second off. The second strobe mode is a flash strobe, where the light is always on for 5 milliseconds. So you have a very fast burst of light that freezes any kind of tool you put on the flashlight. And then the interval is controlled by the setting. So you have a very fast interval, or you can slow it down so you have slow flashes all the time. The third strobe mode is what I call a rim strobe mode. That was heavily influenced by something that Eric Paré did. He used two flashlights, one on continuous light and one on a strobe. And this created a light pattern or light band that was continuously going on and had flashes in between with his tube. So it is really looks like a kind of rim. And with this flashlight, you select a brightness, and that is for the continuous light. And in between, you will always have a 5 millisecond flash at around 60% brightness. So depending on the power setting, you have a bright band and darker flashes in between, or you have a dim band and bright flashes in between. So let's go over it a little bit slower. When you get the flashlight and turn it on, it's probably in continuous light mode. So with a single press, I can now set the brightness of the flashlight, and that brightness is also used for the strobe modes. With a double press, I go into a regular strobe. I don't know if the camera can see this because it's a very, very fast strobe. And with a single press, I can select the frequency, and with each press it goes a little bit slower until you've reached the maximum slowness, then it circles back to full speed again. Now when I do a double press again, you go to flash strobe mode. The camera can probably not see this, but if I make it a little bit slower, you can see that there is single flashes of 5 milliseconds of light. Now I do a double press again, and then I'm in rim strobe mode. Again, it's pretty fast, so it might look like it's continuous light, but when I reduce your speed a little bit, you can see that it flashes. Now the fourth mode is a single flash mode, and there the light turns off, so don't be alarmed. This only indicates that it's in flash mode. And a double press again, I'll go back to the continuous light mode. This is also a very good way to see on what mode it is. Just cycle till you reach the flash mode where the light goes off, and then you know another double press, and then you're in continuous light mode again, and you can select whatever mode you want from there. I hope I was able to give you some insight of how this light works and what you can do with it. If you have any more questions, don't hesitate to put them in the comments. I will try to answer all of your questions there. Have a good day and see you later.